A very good morning, good afternoon to all my dear students and once again Admis Tech team. I'm really thankful to Admis Tech team and RKE University management for providing me this wonderful opportunity to conduct the sessions for IND SAT examination. Now, since we are onto this last session topic of our main booster session agenda, that was specifically dealing with the booster session on quantitative aptitude. So we will start off with the session soon, but before starting it, I need a confirmation from your end that the screen which I've shared is well displayed on your device and my voice is properly audible to everyone. You can type Y for the confirmation in the chat window. Okay, so thank you for the confirmation, students. We'll start off with the session. Now, our today's session is once again from the series of booster session on quantitative aptitude. And once again, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Professor Nimesh Davda, and I'm working as a lecturer and central training and placement officer at RKE University, Rajkot, Gujarat, India. And today we are here to discuss the chapter number 4, which is ratios and proportions. Okay, since these three chapters are already covered up in the previous sessions, so we will be starting off with our last chapter, that is chapter number 4, name is ratios and proportions. We will be covering up these three topics, namely basics, important concepts, and problems. Okay. So let's get started with our today's agenda. So our chapter name is ratios and proportions. Now, when it comes to this particular chapter, the one question might come to you in your mind, that is, what is a ratio and what is a proportion? Okay, you might be willing to know the basic difference between a ratio and a proportion. So to clear off your basics, let me introduce you with the definition of the ratio. That is, ratio is nothing but it is the comparative study of two quantities. Namely, we can take any of the two quantities like A and B. Okay. And if we do the comparative study of these two quantities, we obtain the ratio of these. Okay. So it is represented by either A upon B or A ratio B. Okay. So this is the basics, that is, we compare two quantities and we ultimately obtain ratio of the same. Now, let me clear your basics for the terms of the ratio. That is, the numbers that form the ratio are said to be the terms of the ratio. So if I write any ratio like 7 is to 13, okay, 7 is to 13. So 7 and 13 are regarded as terms of the ratio. Okay. So this is what the fundamental part of ratio. Then after, the terms antecedent and consequent. Now, what is antecedent? What is consequent? Let's have a look. Very first, the numerator of the ratio, that is regarded or called as antecedent, and the denominator is said to be consequent of the given ratio. So if a ratio is written as 7 is to 8, so we may rewrite this ratio as 7 upon 8, wherein the 7 is said to be the antecedent. Okay, the 7 is said to be the antecedent, and this 8 is said to be the consequent. Okay, so this is what the fundamental. Sometimes you may come across these terminologies in your questionnaires which may be asked in the examination. So you must be aware with the basic terminologies of the ratio, and for this aspect we are hereby recapping all these things. So this is what the antecedent and consequent, which is all about. Moving ahead with the next term, that is the proportion. Now, if we equate any two ratios, if we equate any two ratios, we obtain proportion. Hence, the equality of two ratios is called as proportion, right? So if I write A ratio B proportion with C ratio D. Okay, so proportion, make sure it is always introduced by a double column. Okay, so A ratio B is in proportion to C ratio D. Okay, this is ratio 1. Okay, this is ratio 1. This is ratio 2. And we say that ratio 1 is in proportion with ratio 2. Okay, so this is the fundamental of proportion. Now, if we try to look at the fundamental part of compounded ratio, okay, if we try to look at the fundamental part of compounded ratio, so compounded ratio of the ratios, like if let us consider that we are having three ratios as A ratio B, C ratio D, E ratio F. So if we want to find out the compounded ratio of the given ratios, then that can be found out by simply multiplying the antecedents, okay, that are A, C, and E, and multiplying the consequents, those are B, D, and F, and we may come up with the final compounding ratio to be A, C, E ratio B, D, F. Okay, so this is what the fundamental of compounded ratio. To understand it, let us take one example that if we are intended to find the compounded ratio of, let us say, 1 is to 3, 4 is to 7, or let us say 6 ratio 9. Okay, so what will be the compounded ratio of the given ratios? Can anybody answer this question? What we need to do, we need to multiply the antecedents, that is 1 into 4 into 6. So 1 into 4 is 4, 4 into 6 is 24, and 3 into 7 is 21, 21 into 9, what is the answer? You may have your responses in the chat window. Yes, very good, very good, very good. So we have 189 as the answer. Okay, so final compounded ratio turns out to be 24 ratio 189. Okay, I will get back to you once again. Okay, since one of the student is asking for a quick recap. So if we are asked students to find the compounded ratio of the given ratios, okay, the given ratios will be like as I have stated the example over here. And what you need to do, you need to simply multiply the antecedents. Now, what are antecedents over here in the given ratio? Antecedents are 1, 4, and 6. Okay, so we need to multiply these and we come up with the answer as 24. And what are the consequents? Consequents are 3, 7, and 9. And we multiply them and we come up with the answer as 189. So 24 ratio 189 is the compounded ratio to the given ratios as 1 is to 3, 4 ratio 7, and 6 ratio 9. So this is how we find the compounded ratio. This is the fundamental part. Let's proceed ahead now. The concept of duplicate ratio. So if you are asked to find the duplicate ratio of any of the ratio, okay, if you are asked to find the duplicate ratio of any of the ratio, what you need to do, you need to simply do the square of the corresponding terms, right? So square of the corresponding term, let us have an example to this duplicate ratio. Let us say you are supposed to find the duplicate ratio of 4 is to 7. Okay, so 4 is to 7, if you are if you want to find the duplicate ratio of 4 is to 7, then what will be the duplicate ratio? It will be 4 square is to 7 square. And what will be the answer? Please have your answer in the chat window. Very good, very good. So yes, 16 is to 49. Okay, 16:49 is the answer. So this is how, students, you find the duplicate ratio of the given ratio. Okay, you will be asked sometimes in the question that find a duplicate ratio of 4:7 or let us say 7:9. So what task you need to do? You need to do the square of the terms of the ratio and you will come up with the final answer to the said question. Okay, so I believe this is properly understood. Let's proceed further with the next concept, that is the concept of subduplicate ratio. Now, what is the subduplicate ratio? Like we did for the duplicate ratio part, that is we did the square of the terms. In a similar way, for subduplicate ratio, what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to find the square root of the given terms. Okay, we are supposed to find the square root of the given terms. So if you wish to find the subduplicate ratio of 81:121. Okay, if you wish to find the subduplicate ratio of 81:121, then what will be the subduplicate ratio? Yes, definitely. It is 9:11. Okay, 9:11 is the answer. Very good, very good. So this is how you find the subduplicate ratio of the given ratio. Now we'll move on to the next fundamental, which is the concept of triplicate ratio. So like we did, students, in duplicate ratio, we need to do the similar process in triplicate ratio. The only difference is we need to do the cube of the given ratio. Okay. So if you wish to find the triplicate ratio of 3:5, what will be the triplicate ratio? It is 3 cube. Okay, 3:5. And what will be the answer? Quickly have your answer in the chat window. Yes, very good, very good. It is none other than 27:125. Okay, I believe it is properly understood. We will proceed further. Now, like we did, students, for subduplicate ratio, we will similarly follow for triplicate ratio and we will come up with the subtriplicate ratio. Okay, so let us say if you are supposed to find the subtriplicate ratio of the given ratio, what you need to do? You need to take the cube root. Okay, you need to take the cube root of the given ratio. Okay, so let us consider a situation wherein you are supposed to find the subtriplicate ratio of the numbers 64:729. Okay, 64:729. Then what is the subtriplicate ratio of this number? Give yourself a try. 64:729. Very good, very good. And yes, you will come up with the final answer to be 4:9. Very good. So I believe the concept of duplicate ratio, subduplicate ratio, triplicate ratio and subtriplicate ratio are properly understood by each and every student. Okay, we will proceed further with the next concept, that is the concept of geometric mean. So geometric mean of any two numbers, okay, geometric mean of any two numbers is the square root of product of the given numbers. Okay, it is the square root of product of the given number. So let us say if you wish to find the geometric mean of the numbers, let us say 10 and 9. Okay, you need to find the geometric mean of 10 and 9. So what will be the geometric mean? It is the geometric mean of ultimately under root of 90. Okay, and whatsoever the answer you receive, that will be your final answer to the given question, right? So this is what the fundamental of geometric mean. Next fundamental, that is third proportional. So over here, students, what you need to observe, you will be provided with a proportion. Okay, you will be provided with a proportion like this form. Okay, make sure the format of proportion, that is A ratio B, is equal to B ratio C. So in case of third proportional, students, the value of consequent, okay, of first ratio will be the value of antecedent of the another ratio. This is the format you need to keep in mind for the concept of third proportional. Why am I saying this thing? Because after learning third proportional fundamental, you will learn one new fundamental, that is dealing with the concept of fourth proportional. Okay, so don't get confused. In case of third proportional, you are only having three terms, that namely A, B and C, wherein this second term B is present in both the ratios. Okay, second term B is present in both the ratios, and you need to find the third proportional to the given number A and B. This will be the task to find. So let us say if you are intended to find the third proportional of, let me write any two numbers, say 2 and 5. So how to write it? I need to write it like this way. 2 is to B is equal to B is to 5. Now to simplify it, what you need to do? 2 upon B, okay, that is equal to B upon 5. After this, what you need to do? You need to take the cross multiplication. Okay, so 5 goes with 2, B goes with B, and it will be B square is equal to 10. So value of B, that will be under root of 10, right? So this is the step you need to follow. Yes, very good. I found the answer. So I believe the fundamental of third proportional is well understood by every student. See, the process, you need to understand it carefully. The values may vary from question to question. That doesn't make any difference in mathematics. We are having one very good thing, that we are having the certain rules and regulations, and if we follow that, then definitely we may simplify any of the questions which are dependent on the set rules. Okay, so let's proceed further. The concept of fourth proportional. If you observe, students, in the concept of fourth proportional, the basic difference between the terms mentioned in third proportional and fourth proportional, that is, in concept of third proportional, we observe that this B term is common in both ratios. And in case of fourth proportional, we are not having any common term. So what is the fourth proportional and what we are intended to find? We are intended to find the fourth proportional value as A, B, C, and D will be the fourth proportional. Okay, D will be the fourth proportional to the given number. Be very clear with it. So in case of fourth proportional, if it is asked, then always it is value D. And over here, C is the third proportional, which you will be finding out. Okay. Now the concept of direct variation. Now variation, which means something which may directly dependent on the other parameter, and indirect variation or inverse variation, it will follow the concept wherein one parameter will be inversely proportional to another parameter. Now, to understand this, let me cite you an example over here. The example is quite simple. Let us say if the value of the fuel price, okay, if the fuel price is increasing, then definitely the commodities whose values are associated with the fuel price, that will also get increased. Okay, so we can consider that fuel price is in direct proportion to the commodities or the values which are associated with the fuel price. In a similar way, for inverse variation, if we talk about, then let us consider a situation wherein we are having two vehicles. Okay, we are having two vehicles. One vehicle is slower one, another vehicle is faster one. Okay, one vehicle is slower one, another vehicle is faster one. And both start their journey and they are supposed to reach the same destination. But the slower vehicle will take more time to cover up the journey, and the faster vehicle will take less time to cover up the journey. Why? Because with increase in speed, we get reduction in time taken to cover up the journey. Okay, so for same distance travel, we can consider that speed is inversely proportional to time taken. Okay, so this follows the inverse proportion, and this is how the variation rule will follow for direct proportion as well as inverse proportion. And to eliminate the constant of proportionality sign, which you will find right over here, okay, to eliminate this sign, what we need to do, we need to introduce a certain constant value k. Okay, so x is equal to ky will be the final conclusion to the direct variation fundamental for the simplification aspect. And in a similar way, we can come across for the inverse variation as x is inversely proportional to y. So we can write xy is equal to k, or x is equal to k upon y. So these are the fundamentals which you may come across for the simplification of problems based on ratios and proportion. Now, what I insist, students, that you may take a screenshot of this slide for your reference aspect if you wish to simplify the questions based on this particular portion. And do inform me once your screenshot is captured. All right. So it's done. So we'll proceed further. Now let's have a look at few of the important concepts based on ratios and proportion. So very first fundamental which we'll be coming across, that is, let us consider a situation wherein if some rupees, okay, or some currency in general, okay, since rupees is the currency for the India, we are utilizing it. So if certain currency is to be distributed in the ratio x ratio y, then both the parts will be of how much amount? Then that can be found out using this shortcut fundamental, that is Px upon x plus y and Py upon x plus y. Okay. Now to understand this fundamental carefully, we have presented one question which will be simplifying. So let me redirect you to the question related to concept one. So as you can find, the concept one is stated like this way. If P rupees is to be distributed, now over here rupees can be considered as the currency value of your respected country, right? So if P rupees is to be distributed in the ratio x ratio y, then both the parts will be Px upon x plus y and Py upon x plus y respectively. Now the problem is, the amount of rupees 455 is divided in the ratio 4 ratio 3. Now we need to calculate the value of the each part after distribution. So how to do this? Over here, students, let me recite you all the options related to it. You are having the four options as rupees 260, okay, rupees 260 and rupees 195, rupees 295 and rupees 160, 280 and 170, and none of these. So over here we are having the value of P, which is similar to rupees 455. Okay, so 455 can be replaced with P, and this particular 4 can be replaced with X, and 3 can be replaced with Y. And then you may substitute the values and find the answer to the given question. And very good, I am finding many of the responses in the chat. Yes, very good. So let's have a look at the response. And yes, option A, rupees 260 and rupees 195 is the correct answer. So congratulations to the students who answered it correctly. So I believe that this concept one is familiar to each of the students attending my today's session. If you're having any query related to this fundamental, you may raise your query in the chat window. Okay, so I believe it is properly understood. We will learn the new concept, concept number two. Okay, received one query, please re-explain. Okay, no worries, I will explain once more. See, what was provided in the question that if P rupees is to be distributed in the ratio X is to Y. Now, over here, students, instead of rupees, you can assume your currency. Okay, instead of rupees, you can assume your currency. Okay, since it is, I am delivering session from India. So, our Indian currency is in rupees. So, instead of rupees, you may assume your currency. Okay, so if a certain amount of currency is to be distributed in the ratio X, ratio Y, so for that, both the parts, okay, will be given by Px upon X plus Y and Py upon X plus Y. Okay, so now the question based on this particular concept one is framed like this way, that the amount of rupees 455 is divided in the ratio 4, ratio 3. We need to calculate the value of each part. So that can be easily calculated by substituting the value of P with rupees 455, the value of X by value 4, and the value of Y by value 3 in this particular results. And then you will come up with your final answer to be option A, which is 260 and 195. I believe now it is properly understood, since we have other questions also to take. So let's proceed further with the learning of new fundamental concept number 2. So concept number 2, students, that is, if A ratio B, okay, is equal to P, B ratio C is equal to Q, and C ratio D is equal to R, then A ratio B ratio C will be PQ ratio Q ratio 1. Okay, so to understand this, we can also write it like this way. Now over here we are having only A ratio B, B ratio C, and C ratio D, so it can be written like this way also, that is A ratio B ratio C ratio D. The format in which it is asked, you need to understand it properly. Over here only A ratio B ratio C format is asked. So we are writing it like this way, that PQ is to Q is to 1. And if we are asked with all the four terms like this way, that A ratio B ratio C ratio D, we need to frame it like this way, PQR is to QR is to R is to 1. And if we are asked with directly that first term and last term are in ratios, that is A ratio D, but we are provided with this entire set of data, then what you need to do, you need to simplify it like this way, A ratio D is equal to ABC upon BCD, and that is equal to PQR. So let's have a look how to understand this concept number 2 based on one question which I have kept in the slide. So let me redirect you to the set question. You may find the same information over here. So question is, if A ratio B is equal to 2 is to 3, B ratio C is equal to 4 is to 5, and C ratio D is equal to 6 ratio 7. So A ratio B ratio C ratio D is how much? Your options are option A, that is 16, ratio 34, ratio 40, ratio 55. Option B, which is 16, ratio 24, ratio 35, ratio 45. Option C, 16, ratio 24, ratio 30, ratio 35. Or option D, none of these. Now observe the problem statement and the concept carefully. Okay, what values you can replace over here? Just think. Okay, so if A ratio B is given as P, okay, so assume this ratio to be P. Okay, if B ratio C is given as Q over here, then this 4 ratio 5, okay, 4 ratio 5 is assumed to be value Q. And if C ratio D is given as 6 ratio 7, then the 6 ratio 7 is nothing but this is value R. What we are intended to find? A ratio B ratio C ratio D. So what you need to do? PQR ratio QR ratio R ratio 1. Okay. So over here, students, A ratio B ratio C ratio D, that is equal to PQR. That means we need to multiply this three ratios. A 2 into 3, 4 upon 5 multiplied by 6 upon 7. Then we have once again B ratio C. Okay, then we have QR as 4 is to 5 multiplied by 6 by 7. Similarly, we will follow for the ratio R as 6 is to 7, 6 by 7, and then finally it is 1. Okay, so do the simplification and drop your answers in the chat window. If you observe the simplification steps, 3 into 1, 3 into 2, okay. And then once again, if you observe, we have the simplification steps, that is 5 into 7, 5 into 7, 5 into 7 over here. So what will be the answer after simplification? You need to take the LCM. You need to take the LCM. Okay. Let's have a look at the solution. And yes, 16 is to 24 is to 30 is to 35 is the correct answer. Now, how this thing happened? I will show you the complete simplification step. See, what you need to do, students, you need to observe in each of the terms of this ratio, you are having 35 as the LCM value. Okay, over here, 5 into 7 is presented over here. 5 into 7, over here only 7, and over here 1. Okay, so take the LCM, that is 5 into 7, that is 35, and then eliminate that consequent. Okay, so over here we are having 35, so 2 into 4 into 2. So 2 into 4 is 8, 8 into 2 is 16. So I will directly write 16 over here. Then I will do the ratio sign. 5 into 7, once again we are having finally 35 value. So 4 into 6 is directly 24. I will directly write 24. Over here we are having only the term 7. So I will multiply this 6 with the missing value, that is 5. So I will write 6 into 5 and it will result into 30. And over here we are having only 1. So what is 1 into 35? It is 35. And finally, we obtain the answer as 16 ratio 24 ratio 30 ratio 35. I believe this explanation was properly understood by each and every student. If you are having any query, you may raise your queries right at this moment. Okay. So since I'm finding multiple queries related to the re-explanation of this particular problem, no need to worry, I will re-explain it quickly. See, you need to compare the provided question. Okay, you need to compare this provided question with this concept part. That is, over here, this 2 ratio 3 is similar to P value, 4 ratio 5 is similar to Q, and 6 ratio 7 is similar to R. Okay. And what you need to do, you need to multiply P, Q and R for the first term of your answer. You need to multiply the second and third ratios, okay, so Q and R, to obtain the second term of the resultant part. Then only the last, this R portion is to be kept as it is, and one you need to keep it at the end. Okay, so what you need to do now, you need to write it like this way. Answer to your given question, A is to B is to C is to D, that is equal to 2 upon 3 multiplied by 4 upon 5 multiplied by 6 upon 7, and we obtain the answer to your first term. In a similar way for second term, what you need to do, you need to multiply Q and R. So I have kept this two part colon over here, then 4 upon 5 product with 6 upon 7, once again colon part over here, and we have only 6 upon 7, once again colon, and we have 1. Okay, so if you do the further simplifications, what you will come to know, very first 3 into 1, 3 into 2. And you will observe, students, that the LCM value of this denominators, see 5 and 7 in the first part, okay? That is 5 into 7 is 35. So 35 we obtain as a consequent over here. Similarly, over here we obtain 35. Similar, over here we are having only 7 and over here we are having only 1. So LCM value of 35 and 7 and 1 is 35. Okay, you can try finding the LCM by yourself. LCM is already taught to you how to find it. So LCM value of 35 and 7 and 1 is 35. So you need to take the LCM and eliminate the denominator. Okay, then after taking the LCM, you need to eliminate the denominator. So now if you observe the first term of the resultant, we are having 35 over here LCM. So over here the numerator will be as it is, 2 into 4 into 2. So it is 16. Similarly, for the second term, we are having 6 into 4, that is 24. Why? Because 35 is the consequent, so we are not doing anything. Then after 7 is over here, we are missing with the term 5 in the product. Why? Because 7 into 5 is 35. Similarly, we have 6 into 5 to be the answer as 30. And over here, entire 35 value is missing. So 1 into 35, that is 35. So I will write 35 over here. And finally, we are done with the solution. All right. Now, I believe it is properly understood. Please confirm it. Okay. Now, let us try to understand the fundamental of concept 3. So, concept 3 fundamental follows. If XA equals YB equals ZC, then A ratio B ratio C is equal to YZ ratio ZX ratio XY. And if A ratio B ratio C is equal to 1 upon X ratio 1 upon Y ratio 1 upon Z, then A ratio B ratio C, that is equal to YZ is to ZX is to XY. Okay, so you have the final answer same in both the cases, only the representation mode is changing, right? So either you can have your question in this particular format or you can have your question in this particular format. Okay, so this is how the questions will be framed. And this is the answer process which you need to do in either of the cases, right? So let's have a look at the question based on this concept number 3. So the question, very first concept is same. I will not repeat now. Now, question is, if 2A equals 3B equals 4C, then what is the value of A ratio B ratio C? Your options are 6 ratio 3 ratio 4, 6 ratio 4 ratio 3, 6 ratio 2 ratio 3, or is it none of these? Now, you need to observe the type the question is formed. Okay, how the question is framed, you need to observe that particular type. So, if you observe this concept 3 properly, our question is framed like this way. Now, just observe the values of A, B, C and X, Y, Z. Okay. So, to simplify it, we are having the value of X according to our question, that is 2, Y, that is 3 and Z, that is 4. Now, how to simplify it? We need to simplify it like this way. We need to do Y, Z and that is equal to 3 into 4, which is equal to 12. Then after we need to do ZX, okay, so ZX is 4 into 2, that is equal to 8, and last is XY, that is equal to 2 into 3, that is equal to 6. So our answer is 12 is to 8 is to 6. Now something can be taken common, and finally we will result with the final answer. So if you observe, we can take 2 common from this and finally the proportion, okay, this ultimate final result turns out to be 6 ratio 4, ratio 3, if we take 2 common? And the answer is option B. Yes, definitely. I can find multiple responses in the chat, and they have responded the same answer. So let's have a look at the answer which is provided over here. And yes, we can find option B as the correct answer. Okay, so I believe this particular question and concept are well understood by each and every student. Please confirm it. And if you are having any query, you may raise it right at this moment. All right. So I'm receiving multiple answers as Y. So I believe it is properly understood. I will clear all the annotations and proceed to the next concept for learning. Now in concept 4, students, if you observe, the only difference between concept 3 and concept 4 is very simple. Over here, we are having one more term over that is named as WD. So the four terms will be like this way: A ratio, B ratio, C ratio, D. That is equal to, you need to find out the answer like this way. Or the question is presented in this format, that is A ratio, B ratio, C ratio, D. You need to frame it like this way, that is 1 upon x, ratio 1 upon y, ratio 1 upon z, ratio 1 upon w, and ultimately the final answer will be same in either of the cases. Okay, so either the question will be in this particular format or this particular format, but what we need to do the process, we need to do the process like this way. Okay, and do observe the values of x, y, z and w, how they are associated in the question. So let's have a look at the question related to concept number 4 to have a better understanding onto it. So concept number 4 question. So we have, if 2a equal to 3b equal to 4c equal to 5d, what is the value of a is to b is to c is to d? Okay, your options are option A as 30, ratio 20, ratio 15, ratio 12. Then we have 30 ratio 25 ratio 20 ratio 12, 30 ratio 20 ratio 15 ratio 10, or none of these. The students, once again, you need to observe the format, the way the question is framed. So if you observe properly, we are having the question in this particular format, and you can quickly note down the values of x, y, z and w from this particular. So x value is 2, y value is 3, z is 4 and w is 5, and do this process and have your answer. Okay, so y into z into w, so it is 3 into 4 into 5. Similarly, we have for z into x into w. Okay, so it is 4 into 2 into 5. Then we have x, y, w. Okay, so 2 into 3 into 5, and lastly we have x, y, z, so 2 into 3 into 4, and you need to have your answer then. Okay, so I'm finding multiple responses in the chat, so I'll quickly unveil the solution for you. And yes, your answer is correct. It is 30 ratio 20 ratio 15 ratio 12. Okay, so if you do the simplification, you will come up with the same answer. Okay, so I believe this fundamental and the question which is framed, it is properly understood to every student. Still, if you have any query, you may raise it right at this moment. Else we'll proceed to the next question. Okay, we will move on. All right, so let me clear all the annotations and redirect to the I'm finding one student who wanted me to repeat the question. Yes, no need to worry, I will repeat it. See, what you need to observe, just understand the format of the question, right? That is 2a equal to 3b equal to 4c equal to 5b. See, this is the value which is offered to us. Now compare the concept part with this problem. Okay, so over here, if you do the comparison, we are having very first the question is represented in this particular format, so the solution must be followed like this way. Now over here you need to very first write the values of x, y, z and w from the or from observing this question and this concept properly. So value of x is 2. If you observe, we are having 2a and over here we are having xa. Similarly for y we have 3, z we have 4, w we have 5. And then it is very simple, you need to simply do the multiplication of y, z, w to obtain your response 30. Okay, similarly z, x, w, okay, and it will yield 20. Then x, y, w, it will yield 15. X, y, z, it will yield 12. But make sure this multiplication will result into some value, and then you need to take certain value common, and then our final answer turns out to be 30, 20, 15 and 12. Okay. I believe it is now properly understood. Please confirm it. No, you cannot change the orientation, my dear. You cannot change the orientation. You need to just simply observe the fundamental carefully, and then you need to do the solution. All right, we'll proceed further now to the next question. Now the last fundamental, students, and it is somehow, you know, practical kind of fundamental and quite tricky. So let's have a look. So there is x liters of milk in a container and y liter of milk is taken out and water is mixed into that. Now again, y liter of mixture is taken out and water is mixed into that, and this process, okay, is repeated n times. So the quantity of pure milk in the mixture finally will be given by a particular shortcut trick, that is x into bracket 1 minus y by x bracket over the whole raised to n, and the answer will be in units. So let us say liters are there, so over here answer will be in liters. So to understand this fundamental, let's have a look at the question which is based on this. So problem is quite simple. It is provided as a pot contains 81 liters of pure milk and 1/3 of the milk is replaced by the same amount of water. Now again, 1/3 of the mixture is replaced by that amount of water. We need to find the value, we need to find the ratio of milk and water in the new mixture. Okay, so your options will be 4:3, 4:5, 3:5, or is it none of these? Now to simplify it, just you need to observe the format carefully and then do the simplification process. So concept 5 must be observed like this way. See, over here a pot contains 81 liters and over here it is given that there is x liter of milk. So x value is equal to 81 liters. I can write it like this way. Then 1/3 of the milk is replaced by the same amount of water. Over here what is given? Y liter of milk is taken out and water is mixed into that. So how can we correlate? The quantity of milk, that is the quantity y, which is extracted out, which is 1/3 of the 81 liters of milk. So what is the value of 1/3 of 81? So it is 27 liters. Okay, 27 liters. So what is the process they are undergoing? Let us try to understand it. Let us imagine a situation wherein you are having a container. Okay, let me quickly draw a container over here. Okay, let us say this container comprises of, okay, this is the volume of milk, that is 81 liters. Let us imagine. And let us say that 21 liters, okay, this much, 27 liters or 1/3 amount of the total quantity is replaced by water. Okay, 1/3 amount of pure milk is extracted out and that is replaced by water. All right, so we are having once again this process is repeated. So again, 1/3 of the mixture is replaced by that amount of water. Now, be very careful, students, that in the first instance, we are extracting pure milk and replacing it with water. But what happens in second case? We are extracting the mixture. Okay, we are extracting the mixture of milk and water, and we are doing the replacement for water. Okay, so you need to be very careful. Now, the value of x you are having in this particular, and this repetition process is done twice, as you can observe, once they have replaced and the second time they have replaced. So the value of n for this particular question is 2, and after simplifying by substituting these values of x, y and n in this particular result, what will you obtain? It is 81 is in product with 1 minus 27 upon 81, the whole raised to 2. So 27 into 1, 27 into 3, and 1 minus 1 upon 3, I will write it over here, do the simplification properly. 1 minus 1 upon 3, the whole square. So it is ultimately 81 into 2 upon 3, the whole square. Do the simplification process. So 81 into 2 square, that is 4. 3 square, that is 9. 9 into 1, 9 into 9. And finally, 9 into 4, that will give you 36. So we have, students, 36 liters of pure milk after replacement. Okay. This 36 liters is the quantity of pure milk after replacement. So what will be the value of water? It is very simple. 81 minus 36. Okay. And that will yield how much? What is 81 minus 36? Very good. It is 45. And we need to take the ratio of what to what? Find the ratio of milk and water. So milk is 36 liters. Water is 45 liters. So 9 into 4 is 36. 9 into 5 is 45. We have 4:5 as our final answer. Okay. And that is option B. Now let's have a look at the answer, and yes, we can find 4:5 as our final answer. So I believe this explanation to this particular concept number 5 is properly understood by each and every student. If you have any query related to this particular fundamental, you may raise it right at this point of time in the chat window. Shall we proceed? Okay, I'm finding 2 queries, so I will re-explain it. See, the fundamental is quite simple. If you observe, you are having at initial level, you are having 81 liters of pure milk. Okay, 81 liters of pure milk is there with you. Now, 1/3 of the pure milk is replaced with water. See, the quantity remains fixed. You are extracting 1/3 portion, that is 27 liters of milk is extracted, and you are replacing that extracted value by water. So now what happens once the milk, pure milk is extracted, you will remain with the mixture of milk and water. And now once again, you are doing the similar process. You are extracting that once again 27 liters, and once again the replacement is done with the help of water, right? So we are doing this replacement process twice. Okay, we are doing this replacement process twice. So if you observe the values which we need to substitute in this particular result, those are x value to be 81, y value to be 27, and n value to be 2. Do the substitution, have the simplification done, and then you will result with the answer to be 36 liters. Okay, but make sure this 36 liters value is for the pure milk or the pure quantity of the thing which you are keeping it in the vessel. Okay, the liquid which you are keeping it in the vessel. Now what will happen, if you wish to find the quantity of water, then what you need to do, you need to subtract that 36 liter value from that 81 liters, and you will come up with the answer to be 45. And now at the final stage, you need to find the ratio of milk and water in the new mixture. So what is the ratio of milk and water? It is 36:45. If you do the simplification, you will come up with the answer as 4:5. Okay, one student is asking how 2 is there. So see, if you find in the given question, we are having replacement done twice. Once you are replacing over here, and once you are replacing over here. So we are doing two times replacement. So if this process is repeated n times, what does this n indicate? The number of times we replace it. So in our question, we are replacing it two times. So hence n value is 2, right? I believe it is properly understood now. All right. Thank you. So we'll proceed further with the next questions. Now the questions which are introduced over here, those are miscellaneous questions. Okay, those are apart from the fundamentals which we had already covered up. Okay, so this requires your basic understanding of the ratio and proportion fundamentals. Let me quickly have the questions now. So two numbers are respectively 20% and 50% more than a third number. So the ratio of the two numbers is how much? Your answers are 2:5. 3:5, 4:5, or none of these. Now, how to do the simplification? It is very easy. See, two numbers are respectively 20% and 50% more than a third number. Okay, so let us say a third number be 100. Let us assume any random value, and for our sake of simplicity, we assume it as 100. Okay, so 20% more than the third number. So first number, that is one number which is 20% more. Let us imagine the number to be 120, and the second number, which is 50% more, let us imagine that number to be 150. Okay, and you need to take the ratio of these two numbers. So what is 120:150? Answer is very simple. 120:150. Yes, very good, very good. The simplification steps are quite easy. And your answer is none other than it is 4:5. Right? So I believe this question is well understood. Still, if you have any query, you may discuss. Okay. So we'll proceed further to the next question. Now see what is given. If 40% of a number is equal to 2/3 of another number, okay, if 40% of a number is equal to 2/3 of another number, what is the ratio of first number to the second number? Quite easy to answer. You are having the four options as 2:5, 3:7, 5:3, or 7:3. Now how to do this? Let's have a look. If 40% of a number, okay, so let us assume the number, okay, one number to be x and another number to be y. So let us frame this question in a mathematical way. So if 40% of x, okay, 40% of x is equal to 2/3 of another number, so 2/3 of y, we need to find the ratio of x and y. Now how to simplify this? 40% of x can be written as 40/100 into x is equal to 2/3 into y, and you need to find the answer for x upon y. Okay, x upon y is equal to how much? So it is 2/3 into 100/40, and then you will come up with your final answer. Okay, so once you do the simplification, yes, definitely I am finding multiple responses and those are correct. That is option C. Okay, so option C, that is 5:3, is the correct answer to the given question. Okay, so we'll proceed further. I believe this is properly understood once again. Next question, two numbers are in the ratio 3:5. If 9 is subtracted from each, the new numbers are in the ratio 12:23. The smaller number is how much? It is very easy question. Options are 33, 27, 24, and 22. Okay, so we are having two numbers. Let us say the numbers are x and y. Okay, now x upon y, that is equal to 3/5. This is the first relation we are having. Now what is given that if 9 is subtracted from each, so x minus 9 upon y minus 9, okay, we have the new numbers to be in the ratio 12:23. Now you need to do the cross multiplication and do the simplification process. It is very easy. So 23 gets multiplied with x minus 9, y minus 9 gets multiplied with 12. So 23 into x minus 9, okay, is equal to 12 into y minus 9. And then 23x, okay, do the simplification. So we have, yes, very good. 23x minus 207 is equal to 12y minus 108. Okay. Now you can substitute. Let us try to consider that x equal to 3 upon 5y and substitute this value of x in this equation. Okay. And you will obtain the value of y and do the simplification process later on. Yes, so once you will do the simplification steps further, you will come up with the final answer to be option A, 33. Right? Process is very simple, only basic algebraic simplification is needed. So I believe this is properly understood. You can type y. Okay, we'll proceed next. Now see, we are asked with the concept of fourth proportional, that is the fourth proportional to the given terms 5, 8, 15 is what? So answer is, options are 18, 24, 19 or 20. So if you remember students, we were having A, B, C, okay, A comma B comma C comma D. We need to find the value of D. Now, how you were writing the proportional value? A is to B is equal to C is to D. Now, observe the value, students. So, 5:8, okay, we will frame these by writing in proportional format. That is 5:8 is equal to 15:D. 5/8 is equal to 15 upon D, and then find the value of D. D is equal to 15 into 8 upon 5. Okay, so you have the answer, and yes, it is 24. So this is how, students, you will be asked with the fourth proportional, the fundamental which we already learned in the basics. Okay, so this is how the question will be framed and you are supposed to find the answer. Okay, let me clear all the annotations. And yes, concluding with our today's session, I offer you a few of the problems for self-practice aspect. What you can do is you can take a screenshot of this particular slide and then respond to me in the chat window once it is done. Okay, so that's all from my end. We are hereby done with our today's session, and I'm really
so much fun.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm really thankful to Admis Tech team and Aarki University for providing me this wonderful opportunity to guide the students for the IndSat examination, and wish you all the very best, students. Thank you.